Adventure, are we?
Revelio. Revelio. Revelio.
Ah, but if the air is cool, someone's going to regret.
Tiger!
Someone
there.
Incendio.
What have you done? Nothing.
Accio.
Incendio.
Let's play Predator and Prey, shall we?
Accio. Incendio. Rebellion.
Protango.
Not enough play.
Redacto.
Accio. Incendio.
One less poacher in the wizarding world.
Rebellion. Revelio. Lumos.
It's
Revelio. Lumos. Revelio. Lumos. Lumos. Re- Revelio. Lumos.
Here I am, as good as my word.
We meet again, Richard Jackdaw.
I suppose I shouldn't be surprised to see you. It would take the patience of a Hufflepuff to track down these pages.
Well said. Now where do we go from here?
Follow me. I shall lead you as far as I can, but I fear I may remain a tad reluctant to revisit the scene of my demise. Keep your eyes open for a birdbath. When you find it, say intramuros. I think it's Latin or Greek. As you can imagine, I never paid much attention in school. Shall we?
Aside from the birdbath, anything else I should look for?
Lumos.
Indeed. A few landmarks, a stone bridge, a waterfall, and if I recall,
Revelio.
A lake. You'll see.
Lumos. You've been very helpful. Thank you.
Surprising how much of this is rather unfortunately coming back to me.
Reparo. Lumos.
Yes. You know, the closer we get, the more I'm remembering. Probably best I leave you to it. Simply stick to the path and keep a sharp eye out for that birdbath. Adieu.
Is that Latin?
Or Greek?
Rebellion.
Incendio.
Lumos. Incendio. Lumos. Revelio.
The waterfall. For a thief, Jackdaw's surprisingly as good as his word.
Lumos.
Lumos.
Revelio.
Something oddly solemn about this place. Such regal creatures, stags. There it is. Just as Jackdaw described. Intramuros.
Revelio.
Aren't you a little far from home?
Ranrok knew you'd eventually lead us to whatever it is you're hiding. Attack!
Incendio.
I risk those loyalists will report back to Ranrok now. Let's see where Jackdaw has led me.
Revelio. Revelio.
I wonder how big this place is.
Revelio.
Someone didn't want casual visitors down here. I wonder if any of my spells will help me through this.
Revelio. Revelio.
I'm not gonna touch those. Ugh.
Accio. Incendio.
Revelio.
Revelio.
Platform ought to be able to float straight to me. So can I.
Incendio. Incendio. Rebellion.
Not a headless skeleton in sight. But I may as well help myself to this.
Accio. Revelio. 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 Accio. Revelio.
It's a good thing Jackdaw didn't fall down there.
Accio! Rebellion.
An untouched chest. Jackdaw wasn't very thorough in his search of this cave.
Accio. Revelio. Incendio.
I'm glad Richard Jackdaw left a little something behind him, but where could he be?
Rebellion. Incendio. Revelio. Accio. Incendio. Revelio. Incendio.
That's odd. I'd have thought Jackdaw would have been interested in this loot, but there's no sign of him.
Revelio.
Not a headless skeleton in sight. But I may as well help myself to this.
Accio.
An untouched chest. Jackdaw wasn't very thorough in his search of this cave.
Revelio. Repairer. Rebellion.
It is. The bridge, it's almost complete. More spiders. These can't be what the head of Richard Jack.
Incendio.
Imagine how these spiders have multiplied since Jackal came this way. That's odd. I'd have thought Jackal would have been interested in this loot, but there's no sign of him.
Revelio.
I must be getting closer to Jackdaw's remains and those pages. We meet again, Richard Jackdaw. Thank you for keeping these pages safe all these years. Here it is, the map that brought your doom, Jackdaw. Is there something beyond this room?
Rebellion.
Accio.
Incendio.
What? That's unnerving. What's happening? I've seen this before. Ringgold and the restricted section. Where am I? Oh no, the room's starting to flood. How am I being protected? What sort of magic is this? I can only hope this magic protects me until I'm able to make my way out of here. What is this place?
Revelio.
Can it be?
Revelio. Lumos.
It's you.
Has someone finally found our map chamber?
I recognize you from the Pensives. You're Professor Rackham.
I am indeed. I must confess that I am surprised to see someone so young standing before me.
I'm the same age that you and Isadora Morganarch were when you started at Hogwarts.
You've paid attention. And might I presume you share our ability?
To see traces of ancient magic? Yes, sir, I do.
As you have likely realized by now, our ability gives us a unique relationship with all forms of magic. We can access expressions of magic that few others can. Opportunities will arise that allow you to sharpen this rare talent. Do not squander them.
I won't, Professor. Thank you.
We have much to discuss. But first, a map found in a certain book led you here. Place the book on the pedestal.
I don't have the book with me, sir.
That is unfortunate. I'm afraid we must pause our conversation until you return with the book.
The statues and carvings in the house on the cliffside, those are of you. Are you a seer?
I am.
Did you know that I would be here?
I cannot say more at present, except to say that your presence here does not entirely surprise me.
I'm a bit confused, sir. Why is this room called the Map Chamber?
I assure you that all will be clear once the book has been placed on the pedestal.
Very well. I'll retrieve the book right away.
Good. We shall speak again once the book is in place.
Levioso.
Lumos.
Revelio.
Levioso.
Lumos. Reparo. I found the pages and the map chamber. Why would I need the book?
What are you up to now?
Revelio.
I'm back at Hogwarts. I wonder when Professor Fig will be back. I did promise him I wouldn't neglect my studies while he was away. Suppose I have enough to distract myself with till he returns with a book.
to learn Depulso, the banishing charm. Useful for pushing objects or adversaries away. Complete the required tasks and meet me in my classroom.
Resource indeed, your field guide. I'm most
Revelio
included.
Levioso,
Lumos.
Revelio. Lumos. Revelio.
Lumos.
Revelio.
Lumos.
Thank you. Excellent.
How are your assignments coming along?
Lumos. I completed your assignments, Professor.
Good. You should be ready to learn Depulso. Let's see what you can do. Concentrate. Do not let your mind wander. You've got it now. If you'd like to practice, and I think you should, perhaps... flinging your classmates about the halls. I suggest having a go at the enchanted books here.
Expelliarmus! Depulso!
Well done. I'm glad to see that you seem staunchly determined to master your spellcasting.
I've always said that travel...
Who do you think will fall from their broom first?
Everybody grab a broom, and we shall get started. Mr. Clopton, your attention, please.
Sorry, Madam Kagawa.
Everyone, please welcome a new student to our flying class.
Hello.
The goal of today is to remind all of you how to maneuver on a broomstick safely, as broom flight is, first and foremost, a means of transportation.
This, I fear, some of you have forgotten.
Diving, rolling, and loop-the-loops will not be taught or in fact tolerated in this class. We'll leave that to professional Quidditch players, like the Toyohashi Tengu.
Boo.
Not a fan, I take it?
Now, let's see how well everyone kept up with their practice over the summer holidays. For those who need a refresher, step up to your broom. Say up, firmly and clearly. Then kick your leg over and rest your weight on the seat. Up!
Thank you.
Now, your turn.
Up.
Up.
Up, you stupid ratty school broom.
Up.
Up. One leg over, so there's a leg on each side. None of that side saddle nonsense. A gust of wind will throw you right off. And if you hear my whistle while you're in flight, ground yourself at once. Good. Now, for your first lesson, fly through each ring in the courtyard. Do take care. The brooms are school property. I want them returned in one piece.
I think I'm getting the hang of this.
Nice balance. Well done. Now that you're acclimatized to your broom, let's see how well you manage with a more advanced exercise, shall we? This next set of rings will take you around the ground.
What a view!
Hello! Nice day for a flight!
Aha! Brilliant!
Oh, the old boathouse. Wish you could have experienced crossing the lake as the first year.
Whoa, our aquatic resident likes to make an appearance once in a while.
Made it. Oh, did anyone else see that?
I say, I watched you fly through those rings. You seem to handle yourself on that dusty school broom well enough. I'd imagine you're ready for something a bit more challenging. But I'm getting ahead of myself. We haven't properly met. I'm Everett Clopton. Am I right in suspecting that a Hufflepuff like you might be interested in some high-flying fun?
Can't say no to that. What did you have in mind?
A bit of a detour, so to speak. Me. The tour is about to begin. Right now, we're flying over the Transfiguration Courtyard. Lovely as ever. Let's hope the headmaster isn't having tea by the window today. Nice to get above it all, isn't it? Ahead of the garden, the Hufflepuff common room windows just peek out. Bit claustrophobic for my taste.
How is Everett flying so quickly?
Here's something handy to know. Lean forward for a burst of speed. Helpful if you need to escape a tricky situation.
Ha-ha! Now that's more like it.
You sure you're not part Hippogriff?
There's the famous bridge. Think of all the magic holding it up. I mean, look at it. And the owlery. That's a bit of solid architecture, isn't it?
Flying tips and a jaunt around Hogwarts. This is quite the tour, Everett.
That's Kagawa's whistle. This concludes our tour. Best hurry back. Dismount here.
And where have you two been?
Oh, hello, Professor. We were trying to get a bit of extra practice in.
Hefty points will be taken from each of you for not following my instructions. Mr. Clopton, I'm disappointed in you. You're in this class because you're still not showing yourself, or frankly, your broom, the proper respect.
But, Professor...
Enough. Class is finished for the day. As for you, you do well to use better judgment in the future. Chin up. That was some rather good flying.
Sorry about that business with Kagawa, but you have to admit, those views were worth it.
It was worth losing a few house points for that detour.
You seem at home on a broom. Bet if you had a fancy model, you could fly laps around Imelda. She's Kagawa's favorite. I could show her a thing or two if I had my own broom. Hate having to return the school broom after class.
Perhaps I have to purchase a broom then.
If you can, you should. Wish I could. I recommend visiting Albie Weeks at Spintwitch's in Hogsmeade. He's always looking to test new models. I'll keep an eye out for you in the sky.
Does it get any more cozy?
Corridor as soon as you can. I have an idea. Somewhere you can focus on your studies, away from prying eyes and distractions.
Lumos. Pardon me, but were you saying something?
Oh, hello. Talking to myself. I'm Clementine Willardsey. Charmed. I was musing on the precious butterflies I see near the edge of the forest. Whenever I come near, they fly off into it. When I was at Hogwarts, we truly were forbidden from entering the forest. Told horrible stories about it, and I've had an irrationally intense fear of it ever since. It's silly, but I'm insatiably curious as to where the butterflies go in the forest. You couldn't possibly find out, could you?
You want me to follow the butterflies?
I do, yes. If you wouldn't mind.
What were the horrible stories you were told about the Forbidden Forest?
Oh, goodness. Everything from students being mysteriously beheaded to terrifying spider dens. Oh, trust me, you hear that at 11 years old. It sticks with you.
Very well. If I have time, I shall see where they lead.
How kind! Students these days have so much more courage than I ever did. You can usually find me right around here. I hope to see you soon. Don't forget, the butterflies always seem to be on the fringes of the Forbidden Forest. Good luck!
Ah, new face. Wonderful.
Hello. Mr. Weeks, is it?
Albie Weeks at your service. Welcome to Spintwitches. Apologies if you came by before and weren't able to come in. Shop's been closed since trade routes were disrupted. Had to travel as far as London to meet with my supplier. And I've only just returned, thankfully with inventory. I presume you're in the market for a new broom? Got a few rare yew weavers available. Ember Dash, Silver Arrows. Wind Wisps too. No matter what broom you choose, you'll be pleased. They're all exceptional, both in quality and performance.
Do you mind sharing more about your brooms?
I've a passion for them. Every detail of every model. Take Wind Wisps, well known for their quality ash handles. Yew weavers are rare because some fear flying them, likely to do with the yew wand's darker reputation. Then you add the Ember Dash, known for its handsome appearance. Working with brooms every day makes me practically giddy. It's one of many reasons I cherish running this shop.
You said disrupted trade routes caused you to close, Spintwitches.
Terrible it's been. Trade routes reported as unusable. Evidently criminals were overtaking roads, threatening hamlets. I can fly safely almost anywhere, but you try flying with an inventory of brooms on your back. No easy feat. Right then, back to work. If a particular broom takes your fancy, just let me know.
Sounds quite the array of brooms. I'll have a look around. Thank you.
What are we looking for today? Nice doing business with you. That item is of the highest quality. item is of the highest quality. You'll be thrilled with that broom, I promise you. Thanks for stopping by. Whilst nearly any broom will certainly be a step up from the practice brooms in Kagawa's class, they all have their limitations. You seem to be a flyer who might be interested in, say, some enhancements?
Go on.
Ha! Knew I was right about you. I think you'll be quite happy with the performance of any broom at lower altitudes. But you may notice that speed consistency tends to falter as you rise. I believe I can remedy this issue. I have some ideas for enchantments, upgrades, if you will, that will improve the performance of any broom you fly. What I need is someone to conduct a broom flight and report back to me so I can perfect the upgrades. As it happens, another Hogwarts student, Imelda Reyes, is using abandoned broom courses for time trials. Clever girl. An ideal situation for collecting flight statistics. If you were to compete for the best time and succeed, then report back to me with how your broom behaved, I could complete work on my first upgrade. What say?
Sounds as if you took Kagawa's class.
I did, but my focus on the technical elements of brooms rather than the art of flying drove her mad. She thinks it fitting I run Spintwitches now. I don't reckon either of us ever pictured me batting away bludgers for the Cannons or Puddlemere United. And I find a certain satisfaction in winning over the naysayers who think I'm maybe too young to run this shop. With your help, I can continue proving myself the most knowledgeable purveyor of wizarding sporting goods around.
Why do you need me to report to you on this broom flight?
I did try to get Imelda to help, but she has some flying habits and quirks that made her difficult to collaborate with. I need a flyer with no bad habits and a knack for flying. Your classmate Everett said you're a natural on a broom. He's forever in here studying the newest models, almost as passionate about brooms as I am. If your rumored talent for flying can help you beat Imelda's times, then having you assess the broom will be invaluable.
How long have you had a passion for brooms?
Since the moment I saw my first Quidditch match. Seeing flyers maneuver the way they do. Oh, some people continue to have their doubts about me and my ideas. I hope that won't dissuade you from helping. I know I'm onto something.
That sounds intriguing. I'll see what I can do.
Thank you! It'll be worth your while. If I'm right, the new upgrade ought to enhance brooms in every regard. And I can give you a special price. The time trial should be a bit of fun too. Go to the Quidditch pitch and Imelda Reyes will sort you out. Once you've beaten Imelda's time, be sure to let me know.
Rebellion.
I can't help but admire Mr. Weeks's enthusiasm.
Revelio.
We have everything a young student might need when it comes to potions. Have a good look around.
Hello, Mr. Pippin. You need help with a delivery?
Yes, I do. A capable student such as yourself should have no trouble making the trip to Cambridge. It's just south of Hogwarts.
What do you need delivered?
Fatima Lawang ordered a few invisibility potions. I used to go myself, but lately Fatima has taken to turning every visit into an argument. Constantly complaining about the quality of my stock. But how can I maintain excellence when she orders so often, giving me no time to brew? If you take this rather irritating task off my hands, I'd happily allow you to claim the delivery fee from Fatima.
I'd be happy to help with the delivery.
You've no idea how grateful I am, truly. Here are the invisibility potions she requested. Hopefully she won't give you too much trouble. She's a talented potioner in her own right. I dare say I wouldn't mind having a look at her potion recipes one day. What can I do for you today? Very good. Now, I hope to see you again. Farewell.
You can't imagine how inconvenient travel was before I invented flu powder.
Revelio.
There they are. She wasn't making it up. Well, we've come this far. Miss Willardsy might get an answer about these butterflies.
Revelio!
Miss Willardsy will never believe where the butterflies led me.
Complete the tasks I've given you, and then meet me in my classroom to learn Defindo, the severing charm. It's typically used to cut an object, but can be a powerful weapon when needed.
Rebellion.
Looks rather dark in there. Never stopped me before.
Nice to see you, my young friend.
Revelio. Accio. Expelliarmus. Incendio. Depulsa.
Revelio. Accio. Expelliarmus.
Incendio. Depulsor.
Revelio.
Sometimes it seems all roads lead to Hogsmeade.
Lumos. Revelio.
Revelio.
You're worrying far too much. Nobody.
Oh, please tell me you have an answer for me about the
Hello, Miss Willardsy.
Well, what happened? Did you find them?
They led me into the forest and revealed a treasure.
Oh, how lovely! I'm glad you were rewarded for your efforts. Perhaps one day I'll be able to bring myself to go into the forest. For now, I'm happy simply knowing there's something so lovely to see, should I dare.
I think there were doxy eggs as well. But surely those were curdle.
It's like a place rider.
Revelio.
Ugh. Shame you're so foul.
Rebellion.
Have you finished your assignments?
I finished the tasks, Professor.
Well, well. I trust you are meticulous in your efforts. After all, shortcuts only ever lead to shortcomings.
Yes, sir, of course.
Good. Ordinarily, I'd say it's not my concern either way, but you... I want to make sure you're well prepared. Talent and resolve are a potent combination. It would be a shame to let that go to waste.
Thank you, Professor.
Don't let it go to your head. Now, let's see how you fare with Defindo. Wand at the ready. Focus. Defindo can be dangerous if you're not paying attention. Very good. It seems you have a grasp on Defindo. I would encourage you once again to practice here in the classroom, for your sake and that of everyone else.
I wonder who lives here.
Rebellion.
Spare a canut, a pickle, a galleon.
Revelio. Incendio. Revelio. Incendio. Revelio.
The Pippin should have been here by now.
Not sure how I'd fare in a little place like this.
Revelio.
Always late, that Pippin. You can't imagine.
Incendio. Revelio.
Merlin trial when I see one.
That Pippin should have been here by now. Always late, that Pippin. That Pippin should have been here by now. Always late. That Pippin should have been here by now.
The pulse. Accio.
Always late, that Pippin.
It's like a place right out of a storybook.
That Pippin should have been here by now.
The pulse.
Yeah.
here by now.
Revelio. Accio.
Always late, that Pippin.
Capulso.
That Pippin should have been here by now.
Wonder who lives here.
Capulso. Revelio. Revelio.
That Pippin should have been here by now.
Revelio.
Off on another adventure, are we?
Revelio. Incendio.
Seems a pleasant enough little place.
Always late, that Pippin. That Pippin should have been here by now.
always late that
Divorce.
Revelio.
I've always said that. Broadens the mind. That Pippin should have been here by now.
Madam Luang, I have a delivery from J. Pippin's potions.
Sent a child to do his work for him, did he? Always cutting corners and taking the easy way out. Did he have you brew them for him as well? Doesn't matter. You could probably do it better than he can anyway.
Why do you keep ordering from him if you think the quality to be inferior?
It would seem I have more and more customers who are trying to stay out of sight. I'm not one to judge. You can simply imagine the stress I'm under to deliver quality products. Unlike some vendors, I strive to keep my customers satisfied.
Here are the potions you requested.
You think it's so simple? I know Pippin is always trying to cheat his customers. Cutting corners to save some galleons for himself at the expense of quality. You'll not be getting a canut out of me until you prove the potion works. Drink it.
Seems simple enough. I'll do it.
I should think so.
Dash of powdered bat spleen, I think.
Meet, here I come.
Welcome. Do let me know if I can be of any assistance at all. wise decision. Thank you. I hope to see you again.
Not sure how I'd fare in a little place like this. It seems to have worked.
Well, I suppose that will do.
If the demand for potions is as high as you say, have you considered being easier to work with? Perhaps combining your recipes and skills?
Ha! Not a chance. That ne'er-do-well had his shop handed to him. The rest of us had to make our own way. I'll not give him the benefit of my hard work and gumption. If he fails on his own, so be it.
You mentioned that more and more customers are trying to stay out of sight. Why?
Well, I can't speak for all of them, but certainly my Ashwinder customers have their reasons. If I were you, I'd forget I heard that.
Very well. I shall let Mr. Pippin know I delivered the potions as requested.
You do that.
What do you have for sale?
What are we looking for today? Thank you for stopping in. Appreciate it.
Does it get any more cozy than Hogsmeade?
Found a bit of treasure. Come on in. Healing potions are a speciality here, should you need any.
I delivered the potions to Fatima Luang.
Very good. And did she cause you any trouble?
Nothing to worry about. I handled it.
Glad to hear it. And thank you again for your help.
It was a pleasure doing business with you, Mr. Pippin.
Likewise. Worth every bit of that delivery fee to have someone capable deal with that witch.
By the way, I found this book of potion recipes in Keenbridge. Might it be useful to you?
Is this Fatima's recipe book?
Oh, I had no idea it was hers.
Some things are sacred amongst potioneers. I shall return it to her immediately. What can I do for you today? I hope to see you again. Farewell for now.
Incendio.
Hufflepuff.
Imelda Reyes? Albie Week sent me.
Did he now? Still tinkering with his broom upgrade, no doubt. I tried to help him once. He nitpicked my flying technique, and that was the end of that. The nerve. Why is he roping you into his broom testing silliness? You've barely started flying from what I know. Caught wind of you showing off in flying class with Clopton.
I don't know what people have said, but I certainly wasn't showing off.
Tell that to the rest of the school. But it doesn't matter. Everyone knows that class is only for beginners, troublemakers, and bumbling baboons. But for some reason, now people think you're competition. I can't be having that.
Perhaps I am competition.
You're not even Slytherin. Could be a useless squib for all I know. Enough of this. Only one way to find out who's the better flyer. I hold one of the fastest times on this course. Let's see if you can beat it. Slytherin versus Hufflepuff.
Can you tell me more about these courses?
Stalling, fifth year. Fine, I'll humor you. This course demands focus. Requires you to anticipate speed and height before every turn. The others test stamina. Three courses in all, built ages ago by former students. Since Black cancelled Quidditch, it was these courses or nothing. I made them popular again. Got the whole school hungry to compete. So, let's see what you've got, fifth year.
Actually, why not? I can beat your record.
I'm so looking forward to seeing you lose.
Made it. Excellent. Too bad.
Ugh, that's not... You must have cheated, you... Ugh. Fine, you won. Don't think this is over. You can't determine skill from one single trial.
Surely my win means something.
You're not terrible. But you're still going to have to prove yourself if you want to earn my respect.
Challenge accepted, then.
Perhaps you have what it takes after all. We shall see. But don't get your hopes up. The next course near Irondale offers a much tougher challenge. You can try to prepare by racing this course again. Just check in at the podium, where the leaderboard is. You can check your time and start the race. We'll see next time if your win here was more than just a fluke, whilst on an errand for Albie Weeks.
There you are. The Cross One's duelist to beat.
Sometimes it seems all roads lead to Hogsmeade.
Oh, you're back! With something to report, I hope?
Mr. Weeks, I was able to set a record on my broom.
Incredible! Miss Reyes must have been shocked. Tell me, how was the broom?
A little turbulent, and it's wanting for a bit of speed, but it fared well enough. I will say that it tended to drift a bit to the left on certain turns. Heard a slight swoosh when I dipped.
Oh, thank you. That's precisely what I needed to know. Drifted, eh? I shall get to work immediately. Even the naysayers will be forced to admit that my work's had potential all along.
Why would anyone doubt your ability to upgrade brooms?
Oh, you'd be surprised. People get set in their ways, worry that fiddling with what's working fine will somehow ruin it. Those people don't appreciate the sense of freedom that comes with quality broom flight, nor do they appreciate all that's involved in the creative process. I have a friend in Rome, runs a shop like mine, says it's worse there. Of course, they do nap in the afternoons from what I hear. And where would we be without enhancements? I mean, if Elliot Smethwick had let the naysayers get to him, we would never have had the cushioning charm. I don't listen to them.
I'm excited to hear more.
I have a very good feeling about this upgrade. I guarantee you'll be pleased. Expect to hear from me soon. How to address the issue of altitude as it relates to speed? What are we looking for today? Thanks for stopping by. Hope to see you again.
Off on another adventure, are we?
I'd better keep an eye on high places around the school for Zenobia's gobstones. Well, that's one of Zenobia's gobstones. I hardly see what all the fuss is about.
Revelio. Incendio. Depulsor. Incendio. Accio. Defender.
Lumos. Were you calling me, Gareth?
I was. After you helped me with that Fupa feather and potions, I reckoned you might be just the person I need. You see, I have an idea for a fizzing, Wisby-inspired beverage, but I'm missing a key ingredient.
You and your concoctions. I don't know how you come up with these things.
It's a gift, truly. So, I suspect the key ingredient in fizzing Wisbys is dried billywig stings. I heard there's a store of them in Honeyduke's cellar. I'd get them myself, but my Aunt Matilda has her eye on me. Thinks I need to focus on potions class for a while, not for my own brews. I was hoping you could follow a secret passage to Honeyduke's cellar and grab a few dried billywig stings for me.
Of course. You never know when you might need a quick means of escape from the castle.
Brilliant, thank you. But you should know that it's not exactly quick. It's the secret bit that's helpful. The passage is hidden behind the statue of a one-eyed witch in the third floor corridor. Just tap it with your wand and say, Descendium.
Are you asking me to steal from a shop?
Goodness, it's not as if I'm asking you to rob Gringotts. Honeydukes is more than enough, and I only need a few. It's a sweets ingredient. They won't be missed, trust me.
Couldn't you have someone buy the dried billywigs things?
They're not for sale, and you never know when the cellar's going to be locked. So, the reliable way in and out is through the secret entrance.
I'll see what I can do, Gareth.
Fair enough. You shall be the first one to taste my newest brew if you can be of help. Perhaps I can convince a meat to help me with my potions homework, get my aunt to loosen her reins a bit.
I'll need to get those dried billywigs things for Gareth if he's to finish his latest concoction. A one-eyed witch statue shouldn't be too hard to find.
Revelio.
Incendio. Compulso.
Lumos. Repair. Lumos.
Revelio.
This looks like the right statue. Password.
Handy resource indeed, your field guide.
Descendium. Goodness. Who knew this was all down here?
Rebellion. Revelio. Defender. Accio. Incendio. Capulso.
Lumos. Reparo.
Levioso. Revelio.
You can't imagine how inconvenient travel was before.
Better keep an eye on high places around the school for Zenobia's gobstones.
Accio! Defender! Incendio! Depulsor! Defender! Accio!
Well, that's one of Zenobia's gobstones. I hardly see what all the fuss is about.
Lumos. Revelio.
A lift. Must be how I get down. Looks broken, though.
Levioso. Reparo. Lumos.
That seems to have done the trick.
Revelio.
Lumos. Revelio.
This castle will never cease to surprise me. I'm trapped. How am I supposed to get out of here? Incendio. Revelio. Incendio. I'm going to have to get past this.
Levioso. Reparo. Levioso. Incendio.
It across.
Levioso, Reparo. Levioso.
Something is getting in the way of that platform.
Reparo. Revelio.
That did the trick.
Revelio.
This must be the way out. I need to find a way to open that gate.
Incendio!
Something smells sweet. Must be close to Honeydukes. Hogsmeade, here I come. Honeydukes. I can smell the chocolate. Now, where would I find the dried billywig stings for Gareth? I have the dried billywig stings. Now, back to Gareth. I can only imagine how his new recipe is going to turn out. Revenue. Revelio.
I wonder if that traveling salesman's still about.
Yeah. Come on in and have a look around. No touching if you have sticky fingers. If I haven't said it before, it's a pleasure doing business with you. I suspect you have a sharp eye for fashion. Be sure to stop by whenever you're about.
They're gouging us at every turn.
I saw what you did! Ha! I have no tolerance for thieves! Hand them back!
Hand what back, sir? Well, we've not took a thing.
Hand them
Revelio.
There's nothing to give, sir. It was only the one.
That's
Lumos.
Ah, the secret is do the hard work first. Revelio.
Revelio.
Oh, hard work and good luck go hand in hand.
Does it get any more cozy than Hogsmeade?
Lumos! Lumos!
Rebellion.
Whatever my task, I can solve it.
Rebellion.
Revelio.
You're back! Nice to see you again. What are we looking for today? Thanks for stopping by. Hope to see you again.
Revelio.
Sometimes it seems all roads lead to Hogsmeade.
Off on another adventure, are we?
Revelio.
Incendio.
Good call, sir.
Lumos.
Vera.
Lumos.
Hello, Gareth. I have those dried billywigs things.
You got them!
Incredible.
Happy to help. Here you go.
This is brilliant! Can't wait to get started. Thank you again. I'll let you know when I brewed my first batch of fizzing whiz beer.
Better keep an eye on high places around the school for Zenobia's gobstones.
Revelio.
Accio.
Well, that's one of Zenobia's gobstones. I hardly see what all the fuss is about.
Revelio.
Revelio.
I'd better keep an eye on high places around the school for Zenobia's gobstones.
Handy resource indeed.
Revelio.
Accio.
Revelio.
I'd better keep an eye on high places around the school for Zenobia's gobstones.
Revelio. 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 Revelio.
I'd better keep an eye on high places around the school for Zenobia's gobstones.
Lumos.
Revelio.
I'd better keep an eye on high places around the school for Zenobia's gobstones.
Revelio.
Lumos.
I'd better keep an eye on high places around the school for Zenobia's gobstones.
Revelio.
Lumos.
I'd better keep an eye on high places around the school for Zenobia's gobstones.
Lumos.
Accio.
I've always said that
Revelio
broadens the mind.
Lumos.
Defender.
Accio.
That's the last of Zenobia's gobstones. I should go and see her.
Lumos.
Revelio. Revelio.
I hope you've had more luck than I did tracking down my gobstones.
Hello, Zenobia. I found all your gobstones.
Really? I didn't think it was possible. However did you do it?
common sense and basic magic.
Well, may I have my gobstones back?
Of course. They are yours, after all.
Oh, how wonderful. I shall dedicate all of my future victories to you. Speaking of which, now that I have all my gobstones back, I wonder if anyone in the common room would be up for a game.
I'm sure they'd be willing to play after the trouble spent getting them back. It's a fine idea.
Isn't it? Oh, we'll have so much fun together laughing as all the losers get sprayed, which won't include me. Very well, off I go. Wish me luck.